I don't have my glasses on. Is that Jasmine?
Yes.
Okay. All right, Nikki. You come on up, Nikki. As I was telling you, that's what the opportunity God did for Nikki here. Nikki, I ministered her over the telephone.
Jasmine.
I mean, Jasmine over the telephone as well with the mirror. But Jasmine took a step further. She came out to the Healing and Deliverance Service last month. And so she is telling others what great thing God has done for her. So I assumed she told Nikki, I received Nikki's request this morning. So the first thing I said, Nikki, was, I wonder if she knows Jasmine and Marilyn. I said, man, it'd be great if she comes to the Healing and Deliverance Service because I'm going to be able to minister her until Monday. And I hate that for her to be tormented all this time, you know, because when you are being tormented, you want quick deliverance. Now, Nikki, if you don't mind, when you share with everybody what you're going through, you come in here and share, if you don't mind, just share with them everything you're going through, what you have written in your delivery request, what you're going through. God's going to set you free. But I want you to share it because others are going to hear this and see this. And they're going through the same thing.
Y'all can be seen.
Yeah. Y'all can be seen. Let's go ahead and share.
Well, I wrote to Amanda and I found her YouTube video on Facebook from Jasmine posting on Facebook. And me personally, recently I've just been tormented at night with sexual images. And it's both men and women. It's like as soon as I close my eyes, these images are coming, and it's not that I'm feeding anything or like have a desire for anything, but it's there. And no matter how much I pray, it's still there. And at nighttime, I see shadows in my room, and you know, sometimes I feel like things are crawling on me, but nothing's there. So those are my main things I'm really struggling with right now.
Okay. Now again, I don't want you to think this was planned because this was not planned. Again, I received Nikki's request this morning, and I saw she was from Maryland. And when I get from Maryland, I think about people I already ministered to, and I know I ministered to Jasmine. I said, I wonder if she know Jasmine, but I didn't know. And for some reason, I was led back to Facebook, and when I did, Jasmine had sent me a message and said, Vanish King, did you get my friend's request that I go to church with? Her name is Nikki. I said, oh yeah, I got her request. I said, but it would be great if she come to the Healing and Deliverance Service. And then I said, but let her know that I will call her on Monday after my program. And I really hated that because I'm like, man, she got to be tormented all, you know, a few more nights, you know, because you just don't want to go through that torment. So later on, I led to my Facebook again. And then Jasmine said, matter of fact, she talked about it last night, and we're on our way. So this wasn't planned here. So what I want you all to do, I want y'all to stand up, and I'm going to minister deliverance to her, but I want y'all to join your faith with my faith for this young lady's complete freedom. It's a spirit lover. Did Jeff explain to you what it was?
No, but I did see some of the videos.
Okay.
Yes,
it's a spirit lover. And what the Lord had revealed to me about spirit lovers, which are spirit husband, spirit wife, but this is a spirit husband. It's a demon spirit that is calling itself your husband in the spirit. Now, we know in the Word of God, it says there's no such thing as gender in the spirit, nor marrying or giving in marriage. God said that. But you know, Satan always say the opposite and do the opposite than what God say or do. Okay? And what I have found out, this spirit, it enters a person, or Satan assigns it to a person through molestation. Somewhere in your past, you got molested. Okay? It's up to you if you want to share that or not, but you got molested. And that's where that spirit entered. The reason why it was successful in molesting you is because of the sin of the parent. The parent was not submitted to God because God has given parent as a children covering. So if the parent reject God as their stronghold, as their defense, then the child don't have no defense. You see? So that's why those demons so easy. I got molested. It makes you feel any better. I got molested when I was young, around 5. My mother's oldest brother, couldn't find out he molested all his sisters. And it point back to an ungodly covenant of idolatry and witchcraft. And then when I look at it, sure enough, his father was in the witchcraft. You see? So somewhere down the line, there's an ungodly covenant of witchcraft. See, now, that spirit husband is getting a little upset here now because it know it got to go. That's why when you teary eyed, that's why you feeling like you feel, because that spirit, it know it got to go. Okay? But God loves you, because God does not want us to be tormented, period, not even in our dream. Here we are serving him all day long with our eyes wide open. When we go to sleep, we've been tormented. We've been tormented. Lord said no. As the Lord told me, Tara, I have some of you, but I don't have all of you. He said he got some of you, Nikki, but he don't have all of you. But he's about to have all of you in Jesus' mighty name. You spirit lover, come out of her. Come out of her mind. Loose her. Come out of her body. Come out in Jesus' name. Come out in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire, consume all that's not of you. Consume all darkness, all evil in the mighty name of Jesus. Loose her. Loose her. Come out. Out. Out in Jesus' name. Completely out. Out of her mind. Out of her will. Come out of her emotions. Come out of her body. Come out. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come out. 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 Out in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Holy Ghost fire. Burn. Burn. Burn all darkness, all wickedness in her mind, in her will, in her emotion, in her body, in the name of Jesus. Completely out. Loose your hold. Loose your hold. Come out of her. Come out of her. I break all ungodly covenant. I break all ungodly covenant by the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her. Out. Loose your hold. Loose your hold. Holy Ghost fire. Consume. 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 Consume all evil. All darkness by your fire. By your fire in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. In the name of the mouth. In your name of Jesus. I close all hope. I break all covenants in Jesus' name. I break all covenants in Jesus' name. All tattoo covenants. All piercing covenants. I break by the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus shall break her from you. The blood of Jesus cut that ungodly covenant. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus set her free. The blood of Jesus. You come out of her. Out. Out. Completely out. Completely out in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. You will not torment her again. Not even in the dream. In Jesus' name. I destroy all ungodly images in Jesus' name. I place the blood of Jesus over every ungodly image in the name of Jesus. For the blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus forgiving her and her ancestors. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. Father, fill her. Fill her with your spirit, Father, to overflow. Fill her with your spirit, Father. Let her see only the blood of Jesus. Let her see you, Jesus, being pierced for her, Father. Being pierced for her. Let her see you on the cross, Jesus, right now. Give her that image, Father, in the name of Jesus. Give her that image of only you, Jesus. Only you, Jesus. Only you, Jesus. Only you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, for filling the door. Filling every void. Every void space, Father. In Jesus' name. Be free. 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 Be free.
The fire is glory.
Your
fire is glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
All honor, all glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Covenant
was not broken. That covenant is broken now. That's what gave that spirit legal right to continue in your life because of that piercing covenant. You won't hear to hear the message, but I'm going to post on YouTube. And I want you to go back and hear the message where the Lord said, we are light for the world. We are light for the world. The world not a light for us. The world is in darkness. If the world getting those piercings, then you don't get those piercings because you are a light of the world. As I mentioned to the young lady before you all came, ask yourself, Jesus, did you get a piercing? And Lord said, no, you don't get no piercing. Let Jesus Christ be your example. Not the world. Not the world. Even though physically you've done what you knew to do, which were remove the earring of those persons, but that covenant had not been severed in the spirit realm. And the Lord sent you to your help. He sent you to your help. You thank the Lord for your sister here. If she hadn't shared, she had not shared what good thing God had done for her, you would never know. Now you see how important when we share what God do for us, because it would encourage someone else. She was still tied to that covenant, even though she took out that the tongue ring and the ring right there, she took it out. Because the enemy, if you notice, the enemy was coming out right here. They were coming out right here, and I looked. Lord said, look in her mouth, and I looked, and I saw she had a person there where it used to be one, right there, and that's where the enemy was residing, right there in that area. Don't follow the world. You got piercings. Sometimes you get piercings, nobody can't see it. Even though you no longer wear those piercings, but you need to ask yourself, have that covenant been broken or disconnected in the spirit realm? Even with a tattoo, you may not get another tattoo, but ask yourself, have that covenant been severed in the spirit realm? I did what I could do in the natural by getting no more tattoos, by repenting, getting no more tattoos. But Lord Jesus, that covenant in the spirit realm need to be severed. That's why I need some help. Take me to my helper to help me. That thing was coming out your mouth. You know, we better be a light for the world. They don't let no world be a light for us, because they can't be a light because they are darkness. You know, do the things you see the world do. Okay, how much they call you odd? Say, I sure am odd and peculiar for Christ Jesus. Okay, so praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. So what I want to do now, Nikki, I want you to share with us, as I was praying for you, what were you experiencing as I was praying?
I couldn't stop yawning.
Demons were coming out. Now, I noticed in my ministry, because God showed me when we first did this, in my ministry, whenever he, because Lord knows, I don't like demons pitching the fit. You know, I really don't. Some ministers love to see that, but I don't. But it's up to the will of the Lord, you know. But he did tell me in my ministry, most likely when demons come out, it's going to be through that yarn. First time he done it, I was like, the Lord said, look at her. And the baby, it was through a Skype video. A young lady in the UK, she had her baby. And in the spirit, she had a spirit husband. And she was, and also she had a queen spirit. So she had her baby, and the Lord knew her heart. He knew that she had fear that the demon would manifest and maybe harm her baby. The Lord knew that because he told me. But he said, but I'm not going to allow them to harm her baby. So here she was, the demon, as I was saying, prior prayer, the demon was manifesting. No. And then all of a sudden, she started yawning, and I thought it was a regular yawn, so I said, oh, somebody didn't get no sleep last night. And when I said, her mouth went too wild for normal. I'm like, Lord, I said, look at her mouth. I'm like, what? I mean, it was wound up there. I said, Lord, that is not a normal yawn. That is a demon coming out of her. He said, look at the baby. The baby was just a playing all on mama, and the demon was looking at the baby, wanting to do this, but the demon couldn't. The baby was playing. Playing on the mama, and the mama mouth was wide, the demon was coming out. I said, Lord, look at this. This is a beautiful sight. You delivering that girl through the yarns. And the baby was playing all on the mama. So that's how God delivered you through that yarns. You pray, we love you. Now you're free, yes. Nikki. You're free, yes. Your mind. Yes. You're free, your will. Yes. your emotions and your body to serve the Lord in spirit and truth. Stay free. And you do what you do. You tell others what great thing God has done for you. And the people that you, other young girls you be around that had those piercings, they might have removed it physically. You tell them you may want to call Advantage King because you might not be disconnected in the spirit realm. And they said, well, yes, I am. Well, let me ask you about your dreams. What's going on in those dreams? Are you having sex in a dream? Do you see sexual images? Do you feel like somebody is laying beside you? You hear someone walking in your room? You know, there will be some type of evidence there that a spirit lover is still there and they're still attached. Okay? So praise the Lord. Thank y'all, God, because I was waiting for you. I knew God had something planned for somebody today. I didn't know who it was, but I knew he was sending somebody. So you thank him.
Yes.
Amen, dear heart. Just thank the Lord, dear heart.